Well, I always was like you'd be 40 in there, you know. But you know the story behind what happened. I mean, there was the entire like 16 piece. A lot of people broke off
from you'd be 40.
Yeah,
yeah. Well, let's try and count them out. So you had the original 16 piece you'd be 40 band going along with that, and then four of them left to become the Beatles, didn't they? One of them left to become Lulu.
Yeah.
And a very successful sex change.
The funny thing is like that bird who... Her name was, what was it? Scirocco, I think, wasn't it? Scirocco?
No, Scirocco.
Scirocco.
Yeah, because she left. It was a man, it became a woman, and then it became a Volkswagen.
That's right. That's right.
Yeah.
She was...
very confused individual.
But she was marvellous, you see, and this is what broke the band
up. Well, 100 miles an hour, mate.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Yeah, she was a marvellous girl. And I always remember the night at the Clientele Club, you know, when Lulu was doing all her stuff, you know.
Mm.
So, but she broke off when she went, and that was...
Like they all did, yeah. Mick Jagger, he left.
He left, and they ended up with the UB40.
You can't fault them.
No, you can't fault them. They're a good band. But the thing is that there's Norman, you see.
Mm-hmm.
Norman, who... this is not the Norman we were talking about earlier. There's Norman, who I really love.
Yeah? Norman...
Not in a sexual way.
Norman who?
Norman. He's a pal. I like
Norman. Just a secret friend?
Yeah, he's
anything
secret.
To do with you before, too?
Yeah, I like old Norman.
That's cleared that up. Lovely. Thank you so much.
I like Norman, right?
Shut up. But I'm down here with young Danny. B&Q do it all. Why do they do it? Let's have a dance and tons of cash through advertising. Yeah. Tell us a quick little tiny bit about that, if you may. Can I get comfy?
What?
You've been doing it, what, how long, 4 years?
Yeah,
the adverts. Everyone knows you for the adverts.
Yeah.
Why?
Why for the adverts?
Why do you do the adverts?
Well, you see,
is it cash or the dancing or the exposure?
It's the exposure. It's the cash, and it's wanting it, to
just
succeed
a,
in some way, you know.
Just to do an advert.
Do an advert.
Yeah. You've done a lot of other ones, haven't you, since?
No. I mean, the do it all is an important one for me. You know, I walk down the road and...
And you do it all?
I do it all. I'm trying to now...
Not dance?
I don't want to dance.
But you do. Do you dance? Lovely. Another man that I think we have a mutual admiration for who does adverts, he does a soup advert, and that's old Sad Mad Gary Glitter.
Well, Gaz Glit...
What does he mean to you? Why?
Well, because I remember at school... What's this? What's it? Well, I'm down in the bank.
It's a can of love, isn't it?
Since when did Kestrel Super Strength bring up stuff like this?
Well,
you know?
Drink it, don't read it. So, Gazglit, what does he mean to you? School days, you've mentioned school days. We're back there, we're chucking apples at someone and going
Busby.
Mad.
Dave Busby.
Dave Busby, all
Dave
right,
Busby.
Dave? Yeah, I hope he's not inside.
Go on, Dave, go on, boy.
Well,
Yeah.
Well, he spent a long time as a dog, did he?
Go on, you six dog!
You've had a lot of stress with dogs, haven't you?
I have.
Down Walthamstow.
I've lost a lot, yes.
On the track, there's got to be said.
I lost a lot of money at dogs.
Do you still gamble?
I still gamble, yeah.
Yeah, that's why you're here.
Yes, yeah. but you're keeping me up on this, isn't you?
Yeah, you got to, haven't you? But getting back to Glasglit, which is a name that I'm warming to, what does he mean for you?
Gary Glitter.
Is it childhood, is it?
It's a childhood admiration. It's he was a wonderful man.
Well, I think he probably still is, mate.
Well, I think he's a lovely fella, and I always used to admire. I remember once I used to sing to myself, you know, when I was lonely at night.
Yeah, lonely, coping with yourself down the bunker. It's pertinent.
Right. I used to sing. I know, you know, I'll never, never let you go, which was Gary Glitter's, you know, one of his big names.
When you sang this, did you have your flies undone at all?
I used to lie there sometimes thinking about Gary.
Mm. Steady. Did you miss me? What does that hold for you?
The Lighty Lads.
Mm. Well, is it Rodney?
Rodney Pughes.
And Fishy, that Fishy man.
James Boland. Mike Boland?
No, never Mike Boland.
No.
Mike Boland in the Lighty Lads, yeah. But no.
No. What is it, James?
Boland?
James Boland.
Mark's brother.
Yeah. So we I like the Lighty Lads, I think.
Why? Simple question.
Because it was about lads. It was larking about.
What, you wanted to identify with it?
Yeah, I did.
What colour? What colour would you paint your bunker?
What colour would I paint a bunker? I don't know. White.
Why?
Yeah, white would have missed.
Oh, white. Sorry, I thought you said white.
What, white with a splash of, what would you say, a bit of blue?
I'd like to paint something white with a splash of white. And then people say, what colour is that? I say, it's white with a splash of white. And they say, where? And I say, there. You're right, I'll have a lie down. It's been a long day.
Oh, look at that. She's never yours, but she's beautiful. God above. That underwear in your bathroom, it hurts, most of it.
I'm with a customer.
Oh, no, Pet, I just popped in to say I'll see you in the Swallow at 6 o'clock.
Oh, Mitch, could you... Oh, I must go. Oh, no, Terry.
Hello, Thelma. Pat? She's foreign. Finish. See you, kiddo.
That's the Lightly Lads. Do you have any aspirations for starring in something similar to the Lightly Lads?
Yeah, I quite fancy...
You identify with it?
I do. I fancy something along those lines. You know.
What about some of the other things you've done? Like, you're doing all that bloody... Kenny Everett stuff and
away. Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. You can just quote. Yeah. Sorry. Do you want to have a look at something?
Yeah. Let's have a look. Come on.
No, I know how to read, mate.
Come on.
I can read it. Well, steady.
What we got here?
All right, go on then. Yeah? What?
Well, we can talk about... Well, yeah, go on.
Yeah, all right then. Cheers. Cheers, love you. What about Gandhi then? You weren't in that?
No, we talked about that earlier.
Not with me, you haven't, mate. Oh, you got a bit of a deja vu coming on there.
All right, all Barry did a bit on it.
Yeah.
You know,
motorbike scene in Gandhi that was cut.
Yeah, well, it was
a stunt.
No, that's not fair. It's not fair to say.
No.
That's not fair to say at all, because...
When Gandhi was going to escape India on the back of a motorbike.
No, what Barry did was come over to
India.
To India. And he drank quite a lot, right? And the trouble, he had a lot of... he had a lot of trouble with the with the customs. No, with the rust, yeah, obviously, but with the
customs,
with the customs,
yeah.
And that, you know. So what we did was, we said, "Here, Bell," we chucked him in a trunk, you know, and he got in the trunk,
and you smuggled him in,
and we smuggled Barry in,
because I read that Barry actually smuggled a motorbike into the country in his body.
No,
it was
that,
just like the content, the whole of his body was just filled out with
no,
metal.
No, that was wrong, you see, that's what everyone thought, and this is the great thing about it, that's what everyone thought. What he did, in fact, was he, like, parachuted the bike down.
Naturally.
You see what I mean?
Naturally, yeah.
And what he did, he parachuted the bike down, it wasn't so much parachuting, it's like hang gliding, and what he did was, he come through the customs,
yeah,
smuggled through in the trunk.
Keeping a little eye up for upstairs there, just thinking, there's the bike, yeah, I can
that's
see
right.
it.
That's right, yeah. And... as it came down, he ran up a hill, and Emil went, "What are you doing? What are you doing?
Pastor, come back,
come
have a drink.
To the bar,
yeah.
Come to the bar."
Yeah, no.
He wasn't having nothing of it.
He's
right?
got a bike, he's got
he
to
was
clip.
Running up the hill. Emil thought, "Why is he running the hill?" And all of a sudden we see the
bicycle.
Yeah, the motorbike.
Yeah.
You know, I mean, it's not like a bicycle, it's like a motorbike.
I just think it was sad that it was cut from the film.
It was cut from the film, and that's unfortunate, I suppose. But it was a good film. It would have been better with Barry doing the stunt that he did. But he never got around to doing it.
Well, anyway, Danny, it's been a pleasure, a chore, and an honour to have you down in the bunker for a bit of a chat.
Yeah.
I understand. I feel I understand you a bit more now than I did when I was 3 and a half.